Over 44 million French citizens are eligible to cast their ballot in the first round of presidential elections today. Polling's been underway since 8 a.m. local time. Voters are selecting two candidates from a field of 10 to go forward to a face-off on May the 6th. But abstention could be the big winner of the day amid malaise about the economy. Our reporter Elena Cassas is at the French Interior Ministry in Paris, which is overseeing the running of the elections. Elena, you have estimates of the turnout so far. How's it looking? Let's take you now live to Paris's 16th arrondissement, where the incumbent president, Nicolas Sarkozy, is heading to the ballot box today. France holding the first round of its presidential elections. You can see him accompanied there by his supermodel wife, Carla Bruni. They're at the Jean de la Fontaine School, as I say, in the 16th arrondissement of Paris. Now, Nicolas Sarkozy bidding for a second and, under the French constitution, final term in office. He just passed banks of supporters outside the school. He shook hands with them. And now he's come into the building to cast his ballot there with his wife. Turnout standing at 70.59% as of 5 p.m. local time. Thank you for that update from the Interior Ministry, Elena Cassas. So, Kate, you say people you've spoken to do not seem too enthusiastic about voting. Turnout at midday, we know, was better than many feared. But voters had been complaining of disillusionment going into these elections. Why did candidates' campaigns fail to engage them? François Hollande is aiming to become the first socialist president since François Mitterrand. He's voted in Tulle in his constituency of Corrèze, from where our correspondent Luc Brown joins me now. Luc, Corrèze is Jacques Chirac's old stomping ground, but symbolic for Hollande too. Tell us what he's doing there today. Now incumbent President Nicolas Sarkozy is bidding for a second and final five-year term in office after a challenging campaign. He's also cast his ballot today. Our correspondent James André is at the Maison de la Mutualité in Paris's 5th district, where the UMP party faithful are due to gather later this evening. James, give us Mr. Sarkozy's programme on this election Sunday. Welcome to Campaign Chronicles. A row over the publication of exit polls is threatening to mar the run-up to the French presidential elections. Authorities have vowed to prosecute anyone who publishes the poll results before voting stations close, but that doesn't concern foreign media. Florence Villeminot is here with me in the studio, and we're also on the line with Jurek Kuskiewicz, the deputy editor of the Belgian daily Le Soir. Thank you so much for being with us. So according to French law, French media can't give the results until 8 p.m, but as a Belgian newspaper, you're not bound by French law, are you? What time are you going to start giving those results?
There's been a big shuffle that's already begun, even before the election has even taken place.
But the danger is, if this kind of information comes out, it can become a self-fulfilling prophecy. So it's really very much in the left's interest for the public to know this.
Absolutely. It's very important to note that this article is from the left-leaning newspaper.